In this instruction video, we will show you how to use the unique Recross over-the-wire dual-lumen microcatheter with three distal exits. The device can be taken out of the hoop and should be flushed in both of the over-the-wire lumens. This can be done either inside or outside the hoop. The blue hub comes with a stylet inserted. Take it out and flush that lumen as well. Bring it back in and use it during insertion of the Recross device. The stylet gives higher pushability during insertion and advancement of the device. The white hub is connected to the tip and to an additional exit port number 3. So the white hub, which is mentioning tip, is connected to both the tip and the proximal exit port. The guide wire should always be slightly shaped, and depending on the rotation of the guide wire at the proximal end, it will come out of either the tip or the proximal exit port. When the stylet is inserted in the blue hub, there's no space for a guide wire. Take it out and flush the lumen in order to bring a second guide wire through the blue stylet lumen. That guide wire will come out of the middle exit port, number 2. So 2 stands for blue. A torque can be used on both of the guide wires in order to rotate them more easily. Both the exit ports are positioned 180 degrees opposite to each other, so they are allowing almost 360 degree access. The Recross can be inserted together with the guide wire. Backload the guide wire from the white tip hub. The guide wire should always exit the tip. So not exit the proximal exit port, it should always come over the tip. Insert the Recross plus the guide wire through the hemostatic valve into the guiding catheter. When the guide wire is already in place, it is very useful to use a trapping device like the Trapit in order to keep the position of the guide wire. Bring the trapping balloon inside, inflate it, check if the position of the guide wire is locked. Then insert the tip of the Recross over the guide wire. So the guide wire is going through the full over-the-wire lumen of Recross, the white tip lumen, and not exiting from the proximal exit port. Follow the Recross with the tip over the guide wire. The black markers indicate whether the tip of the Recross device is exiting the tip of the guiding catheter, for either the 90 cm or 100 cm guiding catheter. Deflate the trapping balloon again, take it out. The proximal end of the guide wire is exiting from the white tip hub, as you can see. An advancement of the Recross device can be continued. Recross is a device that should be pushed over the guide wire, so it will slide over the guide wire. Its shape is not allowing fast spinning. Slow rotations are allowed in both directions, but if the torque tension is increased too much, it is important to stop because the forces will be too high. The Recross is versatile and multifunctional. The cross sections show that the shaft is ovally shaped, and the exit ports are positioned in such a way that they are facing up and down. And this design facilitates the option for re-entry and redirection of guide wires. When a guide wire is ended up sub-intimal, it is easy to follow this guide wire with a very deliverable Recross. So one lumen has the guide wire inside, and the other lumen is free to use, for example, to decompress and aspirate the sub-intimal hematoma. Verify to which direction the exit ports are located. In this case, the proximal exit port is not facing toward the right direction. The second guide wire can go through the blue stylet lumen, and as you can see in this situation, the second wire can re-enter through the middle distal exit port. Because the tip of the device should always follow the guide wire, and the re-entered wires have re-entered through one of the exit ports. The Recross device should be trapped out and in again, and treatment of the vessel can continue while the Recross has followed the guide wire through the subintimal space and back into the true lumen again. For more information, visit imds.nl.